green. Let's go, let's go.
And we already got hit. Sweet.
Incident in sector one. Yellow flag.
At least it was behind us.
Ignore the aero damage. It's nothing. We think that Lebron, Flores, and Fleming have binned it. Sector one is clear.
Oh my god, people. And I'm glad we did not start one place behind where we did, because that would have been an absolute disaster.
Sector one is yellow.
Got a Cadillac in front of us. That guy is gonna have some trouble. The Cadillac is sketchy here.
Good start.
I like it at COTA a ton, but here it's very sketchy. Alright, I have regen turned all the way up.
Vincent is leading the race.
Cadillac's being very cautious. For good reason. Nice gap to the cars behind. We got three positions right off the start, so. Thankfully, Jim said the aero shouldn't, the aero damage should not be bad at all, so. This guy's gonna try to go too wide. Nope. Wow. Alright. Could be worse. Moving off track, so I stayed
green flag, sector one.
Off the brakes, so we went off the tires. We might have hit a 100% brake charge or a battery charge, and that's why we locked up. I'll bump up the motor map real quick, use a bit more. Cool. Down. So if you hit 100% battery charge, you no longer get regenerative braking helping you.
Sector 3 is yellow.
Don't pull out! You... Why? Why?
The car on your left. Left side's clear.
Oh my god.
Damage. You might need to come in and get it fixed. Green flag sector 3.
Oh man, this has been great so far. Alright, we're definitely going to have to repair, because the car feels like absolute...
Yeah, guy on your left. Left side's clear.
Yeah, man. It's normally not this bad.
Box in. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
I think what some people do is hop in with no practice, or they only practice by themselves and then hop in a race. But I mean, that was... You don't need to be experienced to know not to freaking pull out right in front of everybody in between concrete walls. Alright, well, there's still an hour and 34 minutes to go, so maybe we can make something happen. We got another Toyota behind us, so maybe we'll actually have someone to race. I haven't seen that much bad driving in that short of a amount of time. In this game and any of the weekly races before this race.
Your tires are cold, watch out.
Focused.
Gag is now on softs.
Let's try to make it. Back up to P13, but I mean, we're just. We're so far behind. I have to rely on people crashing.
Green flag to sector 2.
There we go.
Green flag to sector 2. We think Flores has binned it. Then Mitchell and Chicane.
Oh, that was the guy behind us.
He's just done a 3:30. The stewards have warned us for cutting the track and keep it between the white lines. There's a car leaving the pits. Should be coming out into clear air. When we exit the pits, we'll be in P15. Box in 5, 4.
All right.
3, 2, 1. Box now. Go, go, go.
So tires are going to be 13 seconds. Will we gain 13 seconds back by the end of this race with new tires? I don't know.
The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 33 Celsius. The pit exit's clear. The front brakes are cold. The leader, Forestier, is pitting.
Alright, well, P13 did not finish. And we're right behind the car in front of us, so we might actually get a P13 pretty damn quickly. That'll be back to where we started. And we'll be able to try to gain from there. So yeah, Flores a minute ahead of us. I don't think. Oh, well, he'll probably play this up. Okay.
Alex Jarre is now in the lead. Gag behind is pitting now. Green flag in sector 3.
Alright. It's P13. We'll probably get Flores back, and we'll probably close in on Fleming if he hasn't pit yet. cockpit, though.
Vincent is pitting from position 8. We think you'll come out just behind you.
You'll only pit again.
Alright, Brandon, the next car is a lap behind. Front is pitting.
Right, I think we'll get past Flores, assuming he changes tires. I guess we'll be easy to tell if he did or not. Back end was rotated a little bit.
Okay, Brandon, there's a car exiting the pits. Heads up.
Alright, so Flores is leaving.
Stay on it. This isn't over yet. V12.
May have not changed tires. So he was 10 seconds behind us, and then... Gosh, come on, Brandon.
Yellow flag in sector 1.
On your left, clear left.
I'm always wearing my own worst enemy sometimes. Right when we were have action, too. Back past this Alpine. No damage, thankfully.
Sector 3 is now yellow. Brake temperatures are okay. It looks like Claude has stacked it in. Porsche curves. Forestier is leading the race. Sector 3 is clear. Green flag.
That was our chance in Flores, too, because he was on cold tires. If he had new ones, I guess. Be cool. I need to check and see if I can set up crew chief to tell me whether drivers take tires or not. I've only heard him mention one person taking softs. That's the only info I've heard about tires.
Sector 3 is yellow. We think Mike has gone off in Porsche curves. Green flag in sector 3. Okay, Brandon, we're halfway home. We think about 38 minutes of fuel left.
Yeah, we'll fuel up for like 5 laps at the end and not change tires, and we should be okay. Someone's not happy in the chat. The rear end of that Alpine is so cool. As cool as it is, I want to get past it.
Half distance. Okay, Brandon, relax, focus, keep it smooth.
We gotta get past this guy because Flores is run away from us.
Right side tires are cold.
Thankfully, we got nobody close that's behind us. So we shouldn't be coming under pressure. Oh, slip up for him. God, that thing's got some acceleration. Keep them under pressure.
Green flag in sector one. Right, Brandon, pit window is open, P11. We'll need to pit for fuel 1 hour, 25 minutes. Into the race.
That Ferrari ahead is back marker, so hopefully catch up to them when it's convenient. I think the uplink's got us on straight line speed. But we need to get ahead of him before Sector 3. We're definitely quicker than him there. Let's let Flores pull further and further ahead. Left. We're past the halfway mark. Yeah, that thing just rockets off. Right on his bumper again, but not be able to do anything. To blame but myself for spinning out into this corner three laps ago. Oh! Alright, it was his turn to do it that time. Alright, can we hunt down Flores?
Come on, Brandon. Nicely done. Your brake temperatures are pretty high.
Yeah, they're fine. Probably. Alright, Flores is 9.1 at this part of the lap, so let's see where we are next lap. Let's make this happen.
The air temperature's falling. It's now 27 Celsius. Sector 2 is now yellow. Sector 2 is now green. It looks like Lebron has gone off in Michelin chicane.
That's behind us. Oh, I see dirt. Flores must have gone off. Got it down to 7.1. He's also in a Toyota, so shouldn't be able to run away from us on the streets. See him.
P10. Lebron behind is pitting.
Does look like, as long as our pace continues like this, both mine and his, we will catch him. Passing him is going to be a whole another thing, though.
Flag in sector 1. We've think that Michelle has binned it in Dunlop Chicane. Sector 1 is green.
Looks like we're catching P8 as well.
Yellow flag, sector 3. We think Simon has gone off in Porsche Kurtz. Green flag, sector 3.
On the map, that looks like a back marker, so not gonna affect us. Flores below 3 seconds.
The track temperature is falling. It's now 30 Celsius.
Dirt, that's a good sign. If he did not change tires in his pit stop, we're definitely going to be better off than at this point. P8's in the pits. It's probably his last stop. So they might get back out in front of us. Definitely quicker to be there. Come on, Toyota. Go.
attention to track limits, please, Brenda.
Yellow flag, caution.
Alright, he's pitting.
Sector 3 is now clear. We can see Danny has gone off.
We get another 3 laps before we need to, so we'll be putting in more fuel than him. Or less fuel than him, sorry.
Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate. It looks like Michelle has crashed in Dunlop chicane. Green flag, sector 1.
That is not for position. But the car in front of him is. Got 2 back markers here. It's gonna look a little.
Left side. Keep your line. Clear on the left.
Brake temps look good.
Please don't rear-end us, Ferrari.
Far left. Keep this line. He's still there. Left side's clear.
Flores is now on softs.
Alright, so Flores probably double-stinted mediums and is now on softs for the final stint. Okay.
Left side. Still with you. He's still there. Hold your line. He's still there. Be on the left.
That's a new fastest lap for Alex Jarre. 3:27.3 seconds. Got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
Alright, BMW head. It's fourth position.
Clear on the left.
Alright.
Okay, nice. That's a nice one, mate. We've got cold tyres. We need to get some heat into them.
Very wide. I get a warning for that one.
We just had a warning for cutting the track.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Yellow flag, sector 3.
Alright, we can do 2 more laps.
We can see Danny has crashed. 7th position. Guy in front is 1 lap behind.
What the hell?
Incident in sector 1, yellow flag.
The car just didn't want to brake.
Sector 1 is clear.
That was really weird. It was almost like we hit max battery, but we're not even close.
New front's going into Dunlop chicane.
Well, that's not good for our chances against Flores.
Sector 3 is clear.
Just lost 10 seconds basically there.
Okay, Brandon, the next car is 1 lap behind.
of sorts now. Come on, get refocused. Flores is 50 seconds. I think he's going to pass us now. After that mistake. Cutting it very close on fuel.
Acknowledged. Pit stop requested. Very little fuel left. Hit this lap. Hit this lap.
Keep missing the braking marker. I think there's like sunlight on the reflection or something. That yellow marker at the end of the railing, and I'm not seeing it.
That's 20 minutes to go. 20 minutes. Leave the pits, we think we'll be in P9. Behind, Alex Jar. We're running on fumes, mate. Box this lap, please, Brandon.
I want to add more fuel just in case, but I just don't think... I need more than 50%. Oh boy, we're cutting it close. What are 52? Big slap should be more than enough. Even if we have to do an extra one.
Cut the track. Keep it nice and tidy.
Where's he gonna start gaining?
4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
It's a long pit road.
All done, go.
So crew chief clearly only worries about tires, not fuel. Man, this is going to be so close.
The leader, Forestier, is pitting.
I think we're going to be in front of him, though.
Pit exit's clear. Don't cross the white line.
Good tires, though. Not brand new, but just cool.
New fastest lap for Alex Jarre. 3:26.9 seconds. Alex Jarre is now leading.
Flores is on softs, we're on use mediums. Let's see if we can hold him off. 16 minutes, we got enough fuel. Should have enough fuel.
Okay, Brandon, 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes.
There. Thank you.
incident, Sector 3, yellow flag. P8, the leader, Alex Jar, is pitting. We think that Vincent has gone off in Porsche Kurtz.
Flores is under 4 seconds now.
Green flag sector 3, Forestier is leading the race.
Flores must have made a mistake or something and dropped back a little bit.
The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 28 Celsius. Danny ahead is pitting.
Alright, so we're gonna get another
stay
position.
Between the lines, please, Brendan. Ten minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left.
Pleasant. Alright, so P7's definitely as good as we're gonna get, even if the car ahead has to pit. Only the closest one, and it's still 72 seconds.
Incident in sector 2, yellow flag.
Even if you change tires,
we
he's not gonna be
Lebron
putting in enough fuel to
PlayStation chicane.
Make a pit stop that long. That is assuming nobody does, you know, nobody crashes or anything. It can always happen. I am starting to worry about fuel, though. So I think we are going to be going 3 more laps, and we only got 2.9 meters, or 2.9 laps worth. I don't think we'll have to do 4 more laps, but... this is going to be very close.
Green flag, sector 2, P7. Okay, pit stop requested. Watch your speed.
Do that just yet. We're gonna fuel save, I guess. Should use more virtual energy.
Pit crew is ready.
Oh, this is not good.
Incident in sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. We think that Dominiac has gone off in Porsche curves. Sector 3 is clear. Green flag.
I'm gonna wait till the last minute to pit if we have to.
To go, 5 minutes left. Keep digging.
Some lift and coast.
We expect to exit the pits in position 10, behind Danny.
Not pitting. Ooh, P5 is pitting.
Sector 3 is now yellow. We think Michelle has stacked it in Indianapolis.
We're only 0.1 laps short.
Very little fuel left.
So, engineer's saying one lap to go, so we may... I don't know if he means until pit stop or...
Car in front is one lap behind.
At the end of the race, depends on where P1 is, but I imagine we're going to do another lap. Flores isn't really gaining though, so he's either struggling with
one
softs
two
or
minutes.
He's doing the same thing with RPO saving.
See
who P1 is. P1's behind us. But yeah, we're definitely going to have to do it. We're going to have to do another lap unless we slow down enough for P1 to pass us, but we would be losing at least two positions to do that, so...
It's not an option.
We're either going to finish or we're going to run out and not finish. We're not going to pit. Flores is very close though, so...
Sector 3 is now clear. It looks like Korolev has pinned it.
Alright, it does say we have enough for one more lap now.
Last lap, P6. Yellow flag, Sector 2.
Ooh, we are going to be so close on fuel. Still gonna feel safe on the straights, I think. Just to be safe. close. Cross the finish line with no fuel. We're just gonna roll across. I think we got it. Half a leader left.
B6, that's the finish. Well done.
The crew chief was trying to get me to pits. Alright, well, beginning of that race was a shit show, but still ended up getting 7 positions over the whole course of the race. Went P13 up to P10, down to like P19 or something. Then back up to P6. You gain so many positions by people DNFing. Alright, well, even though we didn't get a battle with Flores there at the end, at least kept it interesting with fuel. I do want to see our crash, though, from, I believe it was on lap 1, where that Cadillac just did the worst rejoin I've ever seen. This is assuming Le Mans Ultimate doesn't crash, because we know this game is not exactly most reliable. We'll go back and look at that later. All right, we should be able to watch the replay. If the game crashes, I'll restart the game. Come on, Le Mans Ultimate, you can do it. You can load a replay. There it is. I'm pleasantly surprised our strategy worked. I do think doing 2 full sets of mediums was the way to go. And then just not changing on the final section. I think Flores tried to double stint. He double stinted the mediums and then went to softs at the end. I think what we did worked out better. Because from practice, the softs just feel like they last like 4 laps and then they start letting go or start dropping off. Part of that could just be my driving, but that was the way it felt. And yeah, other than the weird, there were 2 random... It was the same corner. I guess I just braked slightly late, but it just felt like the car wasn't braking like it had been every other lap. As if we were losing the regen ability, but yet the battery wasn't full, so we were getting regen. I don't know what was up with that, but other than that, the Toyota was great. Much less sketchy than the Cadillac. Uh-oh, did we break it? No, we didn't. Okay. Yeah. Alright, it was toward the end of lap 1. There it was. Thank you. as he's off to the left side of the track, and then just... Yeah, there's nowhere we could go. That screwed up the rear of the car. I don't know if the replay shows damage, but... All right, but we recovered from an extra pit stop. I mean, that's the thing. We took a pit stop purely for repairing damage right at the beginning of the race and still ended up where we did. So I can be happy with that. Can it tell us somewhere how many places we gained? Is it here? Yeah, 7 positions. And we are almost... Is the next rating for safety gold or platinum? You might end up going to a platinum safety rating very soon. Interesting, interesting. All right, well... That is going to do it for the stream tonight. I will be back on Saturday morning, actually. I think I'm planning to do the one that's like 9 a.m. Eastern U.S. time. It's the 2-hour race at COTA, all classes, on the Mall Ultimate. So it should actually be listed here. I think it's 2 hours. The only thing is I got to decide what car class I want to do. Do I want to do... Hypercar again? Oh, it's just GTE and Hypercar. Okay. I thought we could be LMP2. All right. I will do Hypercar again then. And we'll see. I'll either do the Toyota again or I might try the Lambo here. The Lambo felt pretty good at Le Mans. I was just more consistent in the Toyota. But I'm better at COTA than I am at Le Mans. So I might try the Lambo and switch things up. We'll see. But yeah, I'll be doing the one on Saturday at 9 a.m. And then we'll be back Sunday afternoon for some ACC GT4 league racing with Pitskill. But that is all I got for tonight. So appreciate everybody who stopped by and checked the race out. Hope it was at least somewhat enjoyable there at the end with balance and fuel. But hope you guys have a good night wherever you are. And I will catch you on the next one. Peace.